Hello everyone, this is Melissa with Low Carb with the Carbs, and today on the Low Carb with the Carbs cooking show, we are making a keto passion tea latte. Now, I hear that these are pretty popular at Starbucks, but just to be completely honest, I haven't been to Starbucks in a really long time because I love my keto cappuccino. But today, I figured I could recreate it because I picked up some of the Tazo passion tea. It says that it's an herbal infusion of hibiscus, orange peel, rose hip, and passion fruit flavors. And I know this has flavoring, so if you're a purist and you would prefer to not have flavoring, then maybe this isn't for you. Maybe you can actually make one with some orange peel, rose hips, and hibiscus. It has a very strong hibiscus flavor and smell, which is really, really good, actually. Very just super fruity from the wonderful flower hibiscus. Now I used 2 tea bags and I put them into my favorite little mug here, my Campbell's mug. I love Campbell's, the Campbell's kids and the Campbell's mugs. I collect those. But I did 2 of the tea bags in here, and then this holds about maybe 12 to 14 ounces or so. But just get you a larger mug and do 2 of the tea bags, and then hot water, hot boiling water, and let it steep for 8 to 10 minutes or so. And I have my favorite, my wide mouth pint. This is actually a quart. I get confused. I know I actually use the wide mouth pint quite a bit. This is a wide mouth quart jar, and I have filled it up 3/4 of the way with ice. And then I also have 1/4 a cup of heavy whipping cream that we will be using to latte this up. And I'm also using the Easy Sweets brand monk fruit and stevia drops. And I got this off of Amazon. You can get a 2-pack for pretty inexpensive. I think walmart.com also has it. I've seen it there before. But these are great because they're super concentrated, and it's wonderful for drinks because when you use the powdered stevia, you gotta shake it and do all this other stuff. So this way, it's quick and easy. And then I also have my stainless steel straw, which I would highly recommend being safe with. Don't run with your drink and a straw, etc. I had gotten a comment before about how they were unsafe. And yeah, just be safe with it, you guys. And then I also have what's called a cuppow. It's C-U-P-P-O-W. This transforms your wide mouth jar into a, you can do it as a sipper or do it with the straw in it like I'm going to. So let's make this here. My 2 cups are already brewed. I'm gonna pour it right on the ice. A couple drips on the counter, not too bad, right? And then pour in, actually, I'll do my stevia next. Let's do the stevia. We're going to do 10 drops. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 drops. And then you have, I'm going to use my straw to kind of stir it up a little bit, getting the sweetener all distributed. And then this is my favorite part. Okay, I'm going to try to do it close to the camera. Well, when you pour in the cream, it does this swirly kind of thing on the side. So let's see if you can catch it on the camera. See how this really almost kind of looks like a lava lamp or something, you know? Isn't that neat? I just think that's so neat. All right, and then I'm gonna stir it up with my straw. Wow, it's really pink. That's a pretty pink. And then I'm going to fill with up to the top with cold water. Since we used a heavy cream, the cold water would be totally fine for that. And then put my jar together. Now I know it's fall. I have my fall apron on. So why am I making a cold drink? Because sometimes when our wood stove gets a little out of hand and you fill it too full, it gets really, really hot in here, like summertime, and something like this is great. And if you're in the kitchen a lot, like me, and baking, after a while, you kind of get a little heated, right? And even with this low-carb lifestyle as well, you burn fat a lot faster. So I hope you enjoyed this video recipe of my keto passion tea latte using the Tazo passion tea, and use any kind of tea that you want.